Alright, so now we're going to look at doing sorting in MATLAB. So sort, you can just do like you would think it would happen. If I have this and I want to sort, so blah equals to sort x, and if I run that, it's going to go ahead and sort it. And you're like, wow, that really shocked. But you should be, because actually sorting is this huge deal. You can like do graduate work in like sorting algorithms, and MATLAB just does it. Now, I don't know actually what method they use to do sorting. If I wanted to know, maybe the help would tell me. I don't know if they get that detailed into it. And if they did, how much you would care. It doesn't actually say what method it uses to sort. It just says that it sorts. I bet you we could figure it out if we wanted to. But anyway, sorting. So there you go. So we can sort stuff. We can sort stuff by descending order. And that's a little weird, but it's a tag. And it has to be in these little quotes because it's text. So we sort X by descend. And it actually just sorts it in descending order, which is kind of fun. Let's see. What else can we do that's fun with sorting? Okay, so here we've got ourselves a nice little blah, 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 blah thing. Let's do this. All right, so those are just sorting vectors is pretty straightforward. But what's more fun is, so we'll call that sorting vectors. We'll call this sorting matrices because it's funner. So we've got this little matrix. I like to make my matrices. Capital letters. Anyway, so I've got this matrix. Now, if I'm just going to sort on A, what do you expect it would do? Well, if you remember or know anything about MATLAB, you know that MATLAB sorts things or thinks things by columns. So like whenever we found the max of a matrix, it would find the max of the column. And in fact, that's what happens here. Whenever we sort A, if A is a matrix, it actually sorts the first column, so 1, 3, 5, 10, 82, 1, 3, 5, 10, 82, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it actually sorts it by column. So each column. So kind of we've kind of done this in other videos, but say you wanted to sort by row. So what would you do if you wanted to sort by rows? Because you know that not sort by rows, let me say sort each row. How about that? That's really important. I'm going to actually kind of emphasize this. Note that I did not say sort by rows. That has actually a totally different meaning. So if I want to say if I want to sort by each row, or sort each row, so basically the idea would be I wanted to go 1, 3, 2, 10, 1, 3, 4, 82, and 5, 5. Think about it. Honestly, pause the video. See if you can come up with a good strategy for it. The more you do this, the more you're going to train yourself to think like a programmer. If all you're doing is listening and that kind of passive learning thing, you're not getting as much out of this as you could be. So remember what we need to do is we need to trick MATLAB into thinking that the rows are the columns. And so we can accomplish this by using a transpose. So now I can actually, if I transpose it, my rows have become my columns become my rows. So whenever I then sort the columns, I'm actually sorting what were the rows. Now, theoretically, if I do this, that should pop them back around, and it does. So basically what I did is I said, well, transpose it, sort the columns, and then transpose it back. And so now it looks like it's all perfectly sorted. So MATLAB doesn't have to have separate functions for sorting rows and sorting columns, because we can accomplish that with just some simple transpose functions. Got it? Awesome. So the reason I said specifically that I did not say sort by rows is sorting by rows is a totally different kind of process. So if I use whatever, okay. So I'm going to call this new section sorting by rows. Okay. So I like to do that. All right. So the idea now here is You might say, well, I'm not really sure what you did. You just added the word sort rows. Instead of calling it sort, you call it sort rows. All right, but now look what's happened. Is you see how this row is 313? The row down here is still 313. 193 is still 193. And then 436 is still 436. Okay? And you say, well, that's really stupid. Why did it just sort the first one and it left everything else intact? And you're like, well, maybe it's not that stupid, because let's say that this was a table and the first thing was, you know, like your name or your ID number. And then the second thing was like your, what's a single digit thing that you have? Oh, your age. And then the next thing in it was your height in feet. That's well, I guess if you're one, you're not 3 feet tall. I have no idea. You could call it your number of cats. Okay, so this is really not important. And then if I was going to go over here and actually display A, come here, then this might actually make a little bit more sense. So trust me, just bear with me. All right, so here's my ID number, my age, and my number of cats. So let's say that I wanted to sort that information by my ID number. So now if I display, I've resorted this. So person number one still has is nine years old and has three cats. And person number three is still 1 year old and has three cats. And person number four, still 3 years old and has six cats. And so that information is still preserved. So does that make sense? This is really, really, really important. The sort rows, so basically with sort rows, sort rows preserves the information contained within each row. Specifically, the associations within that row. So does that kind of make sense? So I think the labeling makes sense. So basically that whatever the first person is, then I can sort by their ID number. And you say, okay, well, that kind of makes sense. And this is kind of fun. So while we're doing this, we can say, I'm just going to apparently keep doing this. But now I can also display, well, we'll call it whatever to. Say I wanted to show it in descending order. So I could go -1. And then display. All right. So this is the same information, but I've displayed it in descending order. So the -1, you're like, well, on the other one I wrote descend, and I don't think that actually works here. Descend. No, that doesn't work. So you can't use descend on sort rows, but you can use -1. But that's actually amazing. It's actually really, really good, because that -1, believe it or not, allows us to do other things. So let me put a little display. Sorted by ID number in descending order. There. So there you go. Now you can kind of keep an idea what's going on. So the first one was sorted by ID in ascending order. So there we go. Now we got all kinds of stuff labeled. It's fun. It's fun to label. All right. So now let's say, we no longer want to sort by your ID number, but we want to sort by your age. So think about what you would do. And in fact, this is another wonderful opportunity to pause the video, try it, see if you can get it to make sense, see if you can get it to work out. How would you think that you'd sort by age in ascending order? Remembering, of course, that age is the second column. Okay, so age is the second column. I'm going to say this again. Age is the second column. What column is age? It's the second column. That's right. All right, so I'm going to keep my little display. So sort rows. So I'm going to sort A. I'm going to sort it by row. I'm actually going to sort it by the column 2. And if you're saying, well, how come I'm seeing blah twice, or I'm seeing my sorted value twice, I'm not seeing this pretty thing that you've got here, it's probably because you're forgetting to put the semicolon there. Remember that the semicolon suppresses your input. And so see now what I got? I have it sorted by age in ascending order. So it would not be uncommon for someone to ask you to do something like this, like sort by number of cats in, I can't spell, descending order. So again, pause the video, see if you can come up with how to sort by the number of cats in descending order. Did you pause it? Did you try it? Again, if you're just sitting here like typing exactly what I type, all you're getting is typing practice. You don't need typing practice. If you're trying to program in MATLAB, well, maybe you do need typing practice, but go do something else with typing practice. There's a lot more efficient ways to do typing. This is not an efficient way to do typing practice. So, if you're going to sort by the number of cats in descending order, of course, that's going to be the third column with a -3 because it's in descending order. And I'm going to display. Now, check it out. You say, well, there are two people that have three cats. Why does it go with this one first? That's because that one was listed first, I think. If I go back to my original data. Yeah, the ID number three person was listed first, so they continue to be listed first. Make sense? Can I see where we're going here? All right, and that's more of what we're doing. Okay. So this is just another example. So say these are somebody's grades, and we're gonna make up the same kind of thing. We're gonna say that you have your student ID, and then you have your, you know, we'll say that these are test scores, and we'll call them out of 10. So test 1, test 2, and test 3. All right, so I'm gonna display grades. All right, CLC. Alright, so as I make these pretty, there we go. So now, like a typical question might say something like, display the grades in order sorted by ID number starting with 1. Alright, then display the grades sorted by test 3 in descending order. So it's like, I want to know who got the lowest grade on test 3, so sort these by test 3. Display the grades sorted by test 2 in ascending order. Okay? So, now, seriously, I know you may or may not be doing this in previous parts of this video, but please pause the video. Go see and make sure that you can get this, because if you can put these together, then that means you actually understand what's going on. If you can't put this together, that means you have no idea what's going on, or less idea of what's going on, and then you really need to go pursue, like, getting it and stuff. So, pause the video, go play around with it, see if you can find exactly how to do this. Alright, so all I can do is big, and at this point, let's assume that you've done so. So, answer 1. I want to display the grades in order sorted by ID number. So that's just a straightforward sort rows, grades. There we go. All right, and I could put labels on this if I wanted to as well. So answer 2, sort rows sorted by test 3 in descending order. Now, if you're not paying attention, you might say -3 because you're thinking it's test 3. But you need to remember that test 3 is actually the fourth column. Okay, so I kind of tried to be a little tricky, and maybe it wasn't that tricky. But test 3 is in fact not column 3, column 3 is test 2. So it's really column 4. Test 3 is column 4 in descending order. And that's what we have there. And now we want to sort rows, sort the grades sorted by test 2 in ascending order. I almost did it myself, so test 2 is column 3. In ascending order. Now again, number 8 person, and then number 4 person and number 1 person are not necessarily in order. And that's because their grades are the same, and in my original lineup, I listed four first. All right, get it? All right, if you can do that, you're in good shape.